Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, ladies and gentlemen. Today we will discuss a very important research which is attributed to Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi, and it specifically relates to the punishment of rajm, which actually means stoning someone to death for a certain crime. Well, according to our jurists, this punishment is specially meant for adulterers who are married and they commit this crime. And as far as people who are not married and commit fornication, for them the punishment has been mentioned in Surah An-Nur, and that is of course 100 lashes. So in other words, in general, the consensus is that as far as people who are non-married and unmarried and they indulge in fornication, then for them the punishment is mentioned in the Quran and it is 100 lashes. And if they are married, then the punishment is not mentioned in the Quran. It is mentioned in the Sunnah or the Hadith, and it is stoning to death. So in this case, by this interpretation, they actually either abrogate the Quran or specify it or add to it. And in other words, they according to their own principles, since they think that the Sunnah can either abrogate the Quran or specify it. So therefore they think that as far as stoning to death is concerned, that punishment is derived from the Sunnah. And as far as 100 lashes are concerned, that punishment is derived from the Quran. The first of them, which is the rajm punishment, is for married people who commit fornication. And as far as unmarried people are concerned, their source of punishment is the Quran, and that is 100 lashes. So this is how generally punishment is presented. Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi has deliberated on the Quran and according to his own principles, since the Sunnah cannot specify the Quran, it cannot actually abrogate the Quran in any way. In fact, if we deliberate on the punishment of stoning to death, which of course is a very, very stern punishment, Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi says that its basis actually exists in the Quran itself. And for this he actually tells us, and in fact we are indebted more to his pupil and student and disciple Ustaz Amin Hasan Islahi, who has ventured forth to explain this view of his own Ustaz. And he has said that there are basically two types of criminals, and we must distinguish these two types. One of the types is in which a certain crime is committed in a simple way. For example, a person steals, or a person kills someone, or a person commits adultery or fornication. This is a simple form of the crime. But when stealing or theft becomes, it takes place on such a vast scale that you actually usurp the wealth of other people. You hijack other people, and you actually, in daylight, it becomes a robbery. So when theft becomes robbery, and when simple fornication becomes rape, and of course we find killing someone turning into aggression of the sort of the terrorism that we see today, then this of course is not a simple instance of that crime. So killing in a simple way is just to kill someone, and when we kill someone in a way that we actually rob, we actually decimate people, we go on a carnage, and we take their lives in a way terrorists do, then this is not simple killing. This is like intimidating the whole society as well. Similarly, when a simple act of fornication is done in a society, that is something else. But when someone rapes someone, a four-year-old girl maybe, or is guilty of prostitution, then this is not a simple instance of adultery or fornication. And similar is the case with theft. Stealing someone, something from a place, and then doing robbery in open daylight, of course, compounds the whole situation. So, according to Ustaz, he says that this compounded situation has been dealt with in the Quran, and the Quran says that all such criminals will be given over and above the punishments of the simple punishments of the simple crime. And for this, Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi has presented that the Quran has spoken of this punishment, and it says that the words are انما جزاء الذين يحاربون الله ورسوله ويسعون في الارض فسادا ان يقتلوا او يصلبوا او تقطع ايديهم وارجلهم من خلاف او ينفوا من الارض. So a translation of this verse is, the punishments of those who wage war against God and his prophet and strive to spread anarchy in the land are to execute them in an exemplary way, or to crucify them, or to amputate their hands and feet from opposite sides, or to exile them from the land. So these criminals who actually cause a law and order situation in the land, they spread anarchy in the land, which in Quranic terms is called fasad fil ard. They are guilty of spreading disorder in the land, and this is actually something which is called that they are waging war against God and his prophet, because when these verses were being revealed, it was the rule of God and his prophet which was set forth on this earth. So it is said that such people shall be dealt with severity. And the most severe of these punishment is taqtil, qattalu, which means that they should be killed in a very, very grave way, in an exemplary way. And the Prophet actually did this by killing certain criminals of rape by actually stoning them to death, because the word qattala means to kill someone in an exemplary way. And by actually applying the word qattalu to his own circumstances, he did stone to death certain criminals who were guilty of rape. And then the next punishment which is mentioned is aw yusallabu, which means that to crucify them again in an exemplary way. The third punishment which is mentioned is that their limbs from opposite sides should be severed and cut off, so that they become an example for the society. And finally, a relatively lenient punishment is mentioned, that they should be banished or exiled from the land. So it's like telling us that if such criminals, they deserve any leniency, then the most lenient punishment can also be given, which is banishing them from the land. But if they don't, then the most severest of punishments can be given. And because in the times of the Prophet, there were people who were guilty of rape and who were guilty of such a heinous crime, so in accordance with this verse of the Quran, which says that you can kill such people in an exemplary way, who take the law in order in their hands, who intimidate people, and their crime is not a simple crime, and it is compounded with many other factors. So Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi has actually explained that we need to understand that when these crimes occur in a compound way, then they have to be dealt in a special way as well. Thus, for example, a simple case of killing would of course be settled with qisas, but when that killing takes the place of terrorism, then we can resort to these verses of the Quran, which tells us that extreme measures can also be adopted. Now what has happened is, in the time of the Prophet, he actually, as I've just said, punished certain criminals who were guilty of this fasad fil ard, who were guilty of spreading anarchy in the land, and they were actually stoned to death precisely for this reason, that they had taken the law in their own hands and had committed the crime not in its simple form, but in such a heinous form. So the summary of Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi's view is that as far as the punishment of rajm is concerned, it is based on the Quranic verse of Surah Maida, verse 33, and specifically the words qattalu, which tells people or tells the state that they can punish such criminals in an exemplary way, and rajm is one such exemplary way in which they can be taken care of. And also it needs to be understood that this is an erroneous deduction which our jurists have made, that people who are married shall be stoned to death if they commit adultery, and who are unmarried, they shall be only lashed by 100 stripes. Because they have not taken into account this fact that whenever the Prophet actually asked someone who was married or not, when he was administering this punishment, the purpose of his asking was if that person actually deserved any leniency or not. It was not because simply the case that he was married that he would be given the punishment of stoning to death. The question of the Prophet, which we pose towards people, which actually caused this misconception for the jurists, that they thought that since the Prophet has administered the rajm punishment to adulterers who are married, hence it's an independent punishment. Whereas the Prophet himself, whenever he acquired from people that if they are married, it was because he wanted to know whether they deserved any leniency or not, or whether they deserved any mitigation or not. And this has caused a lot of confusion in Islamic jurisprudence. And also it needs to be understood, dear viewers, that the famous statement which is ascribed to the Caliph Umar radiallahu anhu, who actually is reported to have said that had he not feared the people telling him or rebuking him for the fact that he had made an addition in the Book of God, he would have written the Rajm verse in the Quran. And if we gather all the texts of these narratives, we do come to know that in all probability, the Caliph Umar radiallahu anhu was actually referring to this verse of Surah Maida, which actually tells us that criminals who take the law and order in their own hand, they create a law and order situation, and who do not commit the crime in its simple way, they can be stoned to death. So we can clearly see that as far as Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi's research is concerned, it tells us how this punishment of stoning is actually based on the Quran itself. It is not based on the Sunnah. There is no need for the Sunnah to either abrogate the Quran or to specify it or to increase upon it. It is something which is based entirely on the Quran. And I would also like to point this out that Ahkamul Usul bi Ahkamir Rasul is the book which is unpublished of Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi, in which he has mentioned this punishment. And it is available online in the form of a manuscript, and his own disciple, Amin Hasan Islahi, as I just referred to, has also explained it, this particular aspect, in his own tafsir. And also I'd like to point out that Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi, where he has explained this punishment of Rajam in his unpublished work, has also referred to the fact that the punishment which was meted out to the Banu Qurayza, the famous punishment we all know, in which their men were all put to death and their women and children were made slaves, he said that it was because of this continuous annulment of promises and broken of promises, because of which this punishment was given. So they were guilty of repeatedly breaking their promises, as a result of which this punishment was given. Whether or not this is something can be debatable, but what we need to understand is that the Rajam punishment, according to Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi, is based on the Quran. It is prescribed for certain criminals who take the law and order situation in their hands, and hence the Quran has given us also the liberty to choose between extreme punishments and to choose between the lesser ones, which are found in the just read out verse of Surah Maida. This research, viewers, has been presented before you so that you can reflect on these words of Ustaz Hameed Uddin Farahi, and of course form an opinion and take into account the fact that as per his principle and the principle that we follow, Sunnah or Hadith cannot revoke or cannot abrogate the Quran in any way, cannot specify the Quran in any way. Of course, it can explain the Quran, but in no way can it specify or abrogate the Quran. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات